Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing about molecular mechanism of gram staining technique. We know this is a technique where we differentiate between two types of bacterial cells on the basis of their cell wall structure, which is displayed by their retention capability of primary dye. First of all, we'll have a brief overlook of how it stains. You know, we have seen in gram staining technique that a bacteria which stains crystal violet dye is gram positive bacteria, while others which does not retain this crystal violet dye and gets counterstained by safranin dye are gram negative bacteria. That's the simple differentiation between two types of bacteria. But why some types of bacteria retains this crystal violet dye while others does not? Let's find out in this video. In gram staining technique, we use two dyes. First is the primary dye, which is crystal violet, and other one is the secondary dye, which is safranin here. The crystal violet is the first dye that's to be used during the staining procedure, and it stains and retains on those bacterial cells which are having multiple peptidoglycan layer in cell wall. As you can see in this diagram, these are the multiple layers of peptidoglycan layer in bacterial cell wall of gram-positive bacteria. While there are some cells that lose the primary crystal violet dye, and in those cells, the secondary dye safranin is used to counterstain these cells. This safranin stains those bacterial cells which are having monolayer peptidoglycan in its cell wall. Now let's see its mechanism in detail. When we see the molecular formula of crystal violet dye, it's C25, H30, N3 and Cl. This crystal violet dye splits into charged species in aqueous solution. It has a Cv positive, which is from C25, H30, N3 part, and it has Cl negative part. So in the aqueous solution, dissociation occurs. These both charged species gets into the wall of bacteria and remains there. The primary dye charged elements, that's Cv positive and Cl negative, are trapped in both cell types. Remember it, that's in gram positive and gram negative, because they are yet to be treated with water and alcohol. After that, these charged species start interaction with the components of cell wall of bacteria. First of all, Cv positive part of dye interacts with the teichoic acid of cell wall. Teichoic acid, being the negative charged molecule, attracts the Cv positive. But this teichoic acid is only present in bacteria containing multiple layers of peptidoglycan that comes out to be gram positive bacteria. While the bacteria which is having monolayer of peptidoglycan does not contain teichoic acid, which is the gram negative bacteria. If you want to see the stepwise lab procedure of gram staining technique, you can click the link which slides in on top right corner. Then we have second molecular interaction, which is between crystal violet dye and mordant, that's used here, iodine. In here, the Cv positive interacts with I negative and forms Cvi complex. That means this crystal violet dye forms complexes with iodine, Cvi complex. This Cvi complex gets deeply trapped into the multiple layers of peptidoglycan of gram positive bacteria. While as in gram negative bacteria, these Cvi complex gets easily washed off because of the monolayer nature of peptidoglycan in cell wall. Then we find the interaction of alcohol with cell wall. The alcohol is used as a decolorizer. The alcohol dehydrates the gram positive bacteria, which shrinks the peptidoglycan layer, thereby enhances the retention of primary dye. Whereas the gram negative bacteria is easily decolorized by alcohol, since there are no charged species interaction in gram negative bacteria cell wall, as teichoic acids are absent there, and it's very thin peptidoglycan layer which loses all the primary dye easily on washing. And those cells which lose the primary color are counterstained by secondary dye, that's safranin, which is retained by them. If you want to see the complete procedure of gram staining technique, you can click the link above that slides in. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you like the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and get notified for the future uploads by pressing the bell button. Thanks.